you could see yourself in my eyes, you'd see a shine, you shine. I know you'd never leave me behind. I am lost this time. Are we destined to burn or will we last the night? I will hold you till I hold you right. If only you could see yourself in my eyes.
All right, welcome back to another episode of Morning Coffee with Rick Alexander. You know, some of these shows are, they stand alone, and then some of them sort of build on themselves. And I find that, although it's kind of annoying sometimes when I have to go back and elaborate on something, like if I just find something from a different angle or whatever, then I like to hit it. And one of our more popular Morning Coffee episodes was one that I did a while ago on sacrifice. And the idea is I kind of laid out an argument for why if you aren't getting where you want to get in life, then the question to ask yourself is, what aren't you sacrificing? And I sort of laid it out talking about some of the prehistoric or biblical times when they used to sacrifice things to the gods or God, depending on the era, and how actually it was almost ingeniously well thought out because they understood the idea of sacrifice and the principle of sacrifice, in that the sort of the actual sacrifice itself was a dramatization of this principle that they understood. And that principle is, if you want to get to the most good or the highest good, right, which is what God is in a religion, then you have to be willing to sacrifice the most. And that dramatization, the actual sacrifices that are described, although they seem horrific to times in our times today, the actual principle, the underlying guiding principle, I actually still believe in. And I think we all conceptualize sacrifice as this idea of like, okay, I want to get somewhere, so I have to sacrifice. So like the athletes who sacrifice going out on Friday night and Saturday night so that they can train. Or we could look at almost all professions that we would consider to be great. You know, if you consider something like a doctor, like they had to sacrifice a huge part of time, which people would consider to be in your prime, your 20s, whatever, in order to get to this goal. And I think the one constant is that really large goals require sacrifice. Now, what's interesting to me is we always think about this in terms of what we need to give physically. And so what I mean by that is, every time, if I tell you to think about right now, just visualize where it is you want to go with your life. And like, what do you want? What are some of the end states of a life that you would consider to be worthy of living? Now, it's most likely that if you were to meditate on these long enough and you consider them, then what you're going to come up with is the idea that in order to get there, you have to sacrifice something. Now, depending on where it is you want to get, the thing that you probably feel like you have to sacrifice is time or something physical, like whether it's time in the gym, time studying for something. Like, we always conceptualize the idea of sacrifice in time and space. But I think what I want to do is elaborate on that a little bit. And I want to tell you this. If you're not getting where you want to get in life, or if you have an idea that is grand and it seems beyond your grasp, then the thing that you need to sacrifice in order to get there, it's the thing that you probably hold the dearest, and that is your belief system. Now, this idea is, honestly, it's so big that I almost have trouble conceptualizing it. Like, I can barely get my mind around what that actually means. But the truth is, if you're trying to get somewhere in life and you are running into roadblocks, then the thing that's not working for you is your belief system. Now, if you challenge somebody's belief system, they hold on very tightly, because it can be extremely unsettling to lose your belief system in some way, or to find that some parts of your belief system aren't as solid as you wish that they were. And so people don't generally like to dive into the things that they believe too deeply, because it can be profoundly unstabilizing. But the reality is that you're getting the results in your life right now that your belief system is going to allow you to get. Like, you are perfectly set up for the life that you're living. And so if you are looking at getting somewhere and you're thinking about what it's going to take in order to get there, I would ask you to reframe this situation and not to think about it in terms of physical sacrifice, like what do I have to give up in my life, but think about what you have to give up mentally. Your chances are you're holding on to belief systems, whether they're limited belief systems, whether it's a belief system that's wrong altogether for what you want. Chances are, if you're holding on to this, you're going to continue to run into the exact same roadblocks because you're running up against the edges of what you actually believe to be true. And if what you believe to be true isn't going to allow you to get where you want to get, you'll never actually get there. And so when I talk about thinking about something great, what is the greatest thing that you could possibly sacrifice? In almost all instances, it's not something physical. It is your belief system. It is the way that you think about the world, the way that you think about yourself within the world, and the things that you think are possible within this world. And this idea is almost so meta that you really have to take a step back from it and try to gain some perspective on your belief to find the outer sort of limits of your belief system to see if that's a thing that's stopping you or not. But a lot of times, you know, this is something that I've clung tightly to because I found as my belief system has begun to erode and I've tried to find things to take its place, even if I'm not in a great place in life, I somehow will like dig in and I'll try to protect my belief system in some way. I'll try to like come up with facts and essentially to bolster the case for why I believe what I believe, which of course is a natural human reaction. The only problem is my question would be, how's that working out for you? You know, and that's the question that was sort of asked to me when I had some beliefs around coaching and around my mindset and around what's possible. And at the end of the day, it's like I wasn't making the amount of money I wanted to make. I wasn't living the life I wanted to live. And so it's odd that I would be in what I would consider not to be a great place, yet I would continue to defend the things that I believed about the world. And I think we do that because to erode at your belief system can be profoundly destabilizing. And I would say the way to navigate that is to try to remain open to all possibilities, right? To find the path. And then on top of that, try to approach yourself with the perspective that everything that you do believe is actually learned, therefore could be unlearned or could be changed or could be swapped for a belief system that is more productive to what you want. But this idea, it's like I said, it's hard to get your mind around. But the bottom line is, if you're thinking about the things in your life and the things that you want for yourself in your life and your family, and your next thought is, I don't think I can get there, or I don't know how I would get there, and that in itself seems like a roadblock, then the thing that you most need to sacrifice in order to get the life you want is your belief system. You need to sacrifice the things that you believe. And I would say you probably need to come to the realization that there's so much beyond what you understand to be true. And it's okay if you don't always have the gaps filled in, but you can't hang on so tightly to the things that you believe, because often those are the things that are keeping you stuck in life. So a little bit of a difficult episode to wrap your mind around, a little bit esoteric, but I would consider asking yourself these questions. Think about the sacrifices that you're willing to make, and then understand that the most important one that you could make is the one that you hold dearest, and that is the lens through which you see everything else. Like I said, I love you guys. If this episode resonates, if you see some areas in your own life where you might need to sacrifice the things that you believe in order to move up and you're having trouble with that, hit me up. I do some coaching on this kind of a thing. Or if you just want to open some dialogue about it, I'm always down to do my best to try to help. So again, @RickAlexander_ or @LionHeartRadio on Instagram, or you can shoot me an email, rickalexander22@gmail.com. I love you guys. I'll talk to you tomorrow on Morning Coffee. That's a pretty big trunk on my Lincoln Town car, ain't it? Big enough to take these broken hearts and put them in it. Now I'm driving round on the boulevard, trunk bleeding. And every time the cops pull me over, they don't ever see them, they never see them. And I got this black suit on, roaming around like I'm ready for a funeral. 5 more miles till the road runs out. I'm about to drive in the ocean. Dun 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 dun.
signals, stay heated. I would've put tints on my windows, but what's the difference? If I feel like a ghost, no sway. Ever since I lost my baby, I've had this black suit on, roaming around like I'm ready for a funeral.
Washing me out. I'm about to drive in the ocean.